Hello everyone. Today we will do the poem Fire and Ice, written by Robert Frost. Robert Frost was an American poet. He has written many beautiful poems. This poem is a short symbolic poem consisting of two stanzas. We all have heard that world will end. हर कोई यही बात कहता है ना, दुनिया खत्म हो जाएगी. In some way or other way, especially we blame the natural calamity, कि हो सकता है कि पूरी दुनिया में आग लग जाए because of fire, या इतनी ठंड पड़े due to the coldness out there, that one day this earth will destroy. But Robert Frost is giving his own views in this poem. So let's see what are his views. First stanza, some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. Poet is saying, some people say the world will end in fire, and some say that in ice. Means some people are saying or blaming that some natural calamity like fire, old, excessive coldness will bring the disasters or destruction to the world, and everything will be destroyed at last. But what poet is saying, from what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. He is saying that I am favoring or I am supporting those people who are saying that world will end in fire. But that fire is fire of endless desire. Here fire is a symbolic word, and fire is symbolizing endless desire. Human beings have endless desire, and due to those endless desire, they are deteriorating the beautiful earth. They are cutting down the trees, they are cutting down the mountains to make ways or roads. In this way, they are destroying their own earth. Their endless desires for their lavish life is doing all kind of these things. So human beings don't need any external force like fire to destroy this beautiful earth. If we will control our desire, our endless desire, then maybe the world would be saved. Otherwise, our desires will end everything. So, poet clearly bata raha hai ki wo unko hi favor kar raha hai jo fire keh rahe hain. But yahan pe fire jo hai wo endless desires hain. Hamari jo ichhaein kabhi khatam nahi hoti. Let's see the second stanza. But if it had to perish twice, perish mean destroy, twice mean second time. I think I know enough of fate. Poet is saying that if world has to end the second time or destroy the second time, then he knows, when that he thinks that he knows that hatred, hate or jealousy, to say that for destruction ice is also great and would suffice. Suffice ka matlab hai yahan pe sufficient. That those people who say that ice or coldness would be there, itni thand ho jayegi ki sab mar jayenge, everyone will die due to that coldness. But here, the ice is symbolic of coldness among our hearts. Among our hearts, we feel hatred towards each other. We can't look the other person in happiness. We feel jealous of that person and always wish that that person's happiness would destroy soon. And that is the real destruction, that we are doing riots, there are fights in the world, there are so many things. So here, that coldness, that ice among us, that is sufficient according to poet to finish this world twice. So it is a beautiful poem and message that poet is giving, that if we want to survive this beautiful world, then what we have to do? We have to control our negative traits. We have to control those traits like endless desires, like hatred, like jealousy. We should love each other. We should pay respect to each other. I hope you must have understood this poem. Now, let's see the word meanings of this poem. The first word meaning is tasted. Tasted means experienced. Second is perish. Perish means die or destroy. Then third word meaning is suffice. Suffice means enough or sufficient. Poetic devices used in this poem are, first is symbolism. Symbolism, the use of symbols to represent an idea, object or relationship. Here the poet has used two symbols, ice and fire. Fire is symbol of desires and ice is symbol of hate. Second is metaphor. It is comparison of two unlike things without using words like or as. Like or as use किए बिना compare करना. Fire has been compared to desire and dies with hate. Alliteration. Alliteration words beginning with same consonant sound. Some say favor fire. वो word जो similar consonant sound से start होते हैं. Like in first stanza, first line, some say S and S both are giving the same consonant sound. And first stanza, fourth line and last two words, favor fire. Again, F and N. F and F, favor fire. These both are giving consonant sounds. Next is anaphora. Anaphora, the repetition of a word or phrase at the beginning of successive line. Anaphora is a poetic device when some word or phrases used at beginning of successive lines means next line से next line जो start होती है दोनों same word या same phrase से start हो रही है like some and some or you can say some say and some say. So this poetic device is known as anaphora. Then imagery, to create image in the mind of reader. Poet want to create an image of that ice, that fire, that destruction. वो जो इमेज क्रिएट कर रहा है पोइट को, दिस पोइटिक डिवाइस को हम इमेजरी कहते हैं. हमारे सामने ना होते हुए भी हम उसको इमेजिन कर सकते हैं. लास्ट इज राइमिंग स्कीम. व्हाट इज राइमिंग स्कीम? द पैटर्न ऑफ राइम एट द एंडिंग वर्ड्स ऑफ एनी लाइन. ओके, जो पैटर्न बनता है वो जैसे कि है ए बी ए ए बी सी बी सी बी. हियर इफ यू विल सी द पोइम क्लियरली देन फर्स्ट लाइन्स एंडिंग वर्ड इज राइमिंग विद थर्ड एंड फोर्थ लाइन एंड सेकेंड लाइन्स एंडिंग वर्ड इज राइमिंग विद द फिफ्थ सेवन्थ एंड नाइन्थ लाइन. सो दिस इज हाउ द राइमिंग स्कीम इज फॉर्म्ड.